A major talking point all year, but Mike, it certainly had some fuel tipped on the fire. You did the tipping with the Mick Malthouse declaration on the front page of the Herald Sun on Friday morning that he will not be at Collingwood next year.
Yes, Jared, that's my view. Hopefully it's considered and informed. I don't think there's any chance of Mick being at Collingwood in any capacity next year. And I think it's the right decision too.
His manager today was emphatic that he won't be coaching anywhere else next year.
No, and I've believed that for a month. Mick said unequivocally, I will not coach next year. Peter said, well, has said the same thing, so I take that at face value.
I listened to your discussion on 3OW. It was raised again by Lee Matthews, the issue that only when Nathan Buckley sits down after two premierships, potentially, for Collingwood, will he feel the enormity of the pressure of the position he's about to take on, and only then may he consider his options.
Yeah, Lee did say that, and Lee is the master of reason in football. I mean, he's just everything he says, it sounds so simple and sounds so logical, but I couldn't understand him saying that. I mean, this is in place. There's no question Nathan Buckley will coach Collingwood next year.
So you're saying your conclusion is based on Mick not wanting to be at Collingwood, or Collingwood not wanting Mick to be there?
No, Collingwood made the change. Collingwood made the change in July 2009.
No, but are you saying now that Collingwood perhaps don't want Mick to be there next year?
No.
Are you saying it's purely Mick's decision not to be there?
I don't think Bucks would want Mick there. I think Bucks wants to go in with a blank canvas and say, this is now my team. He knows he's on a hiding to nothing next year.
Yeah.
And that's even worse if he's got Mick at his shoulder. I don't think they want to be working alongside each other.
Yeah, so you're saying Bucks doesn't want Mick, Collingwood doesn't want Mick, so that's a significant change.
No, I didn't say Collingwood didn't want Mick, but Collingwood know there's a deal in place.
Yep.
So Mick knows that. Everyone knows it. It was just, I think it was a deal of convenience at the time, and then it almost was ruined by the fact that they won a flag last year and they might win one again this year.
The subheading in your, or the subcontext in your column was, though, that Mick should walk away happy, and yet...
Of course he should. There's no question in my mind that Mick should make a graceful exit. If they win the flag, that's four premierships for Mick, two at Collingwood, and he's made a massive contribution in 12 years there. I would like to see him wish Bucks all the best, say, I've loved my time here, and he goes away as an exalted Collingwood figure.
Yeah, I'd agree with that. I'd either like him to come out and say, I want to coach Collingwood, or I'm stepping away gracefully, because I think out of this whole thing, he could walk away from football as a complete legend of the game.
Correct.
You know, a really exalted figure from both of the Collingwood Football Club and Shep, similar to Kevin when he left, obviously he's come back to GWS. But it's interesting, isn't it? It's the way it's played out probably hasn't been great for either party.
I think had this deal not been made, Jared, I'm not sure Collingwood would have made some of the recruiting decisions that they took. I think that they decided when Mick had 2 years left, they decided, we'll go and get Jolly and we'll go and get Ball and we'll try to extract a premiership from this group.
Look, one thing I don't agree with, I don't think Collingwood have lost out of it. Some people have criticised Collingwood. Yeah. I think you're right. Collingwood put this in place, let's be clear, when no one was sure whether they were going to win a premiership. So it was a smart move by Eddie and a smart move by, I think, Purdy was involved in it. It was a smart move. Mm. They might win two premierships. I don't think Collingwood have lost out of it at all.
No, me either.
Full stop, potentially, Mike. And yet,
well, your own view, do you think Mick will be at Collingwood in any capacity next year?
The only way I see him at Collingwood is if Nathan Buckley, as Lee Matthews has suggested, if they win two premierships, says, this isn't for me, I'm going to move on. Mick, you go back and coach.
Well, excuse the pun, Jared, but there's Buckley's hope of that.